Pleasant morning to my dear lovable students. In this conversation, we are going to continuation of exercise 5.2. Okay, I'm moving to question number 5. Write nth term of the sequence 3 by 1 square 2 square, then 5 by 2 square 3 square, then 7 by 3 square 4 square as a difference of a 2 times. Okay, so take it the first one. A means the A1 means 3 by 1 square 2 square, then A2 is equal to 5 by 2 square 3 square, then A3 is equal to 7 by 3 square 4 square, then up to A4 also. So 3, 5, 7 means definitely 9 by 4 square and 5 square up to dot dot dot. Definitely AN means, look at there, starting with 2 means 2 square, A3 means starting 3 square. So denominator definitely we can say n square. Then next term 3 plus 1, isn't it? Here 2 plus 1 means 3, 1 plus 1 means 2, 4 plus 1 means 5. Therefore n plus 1 the whole square. Then numerator 3, 5, 7, 9 is there, isn't it? So definitely 3, 5, 7, 9 means what will happen? 2n plus 1, isn't it? So 2n minus 1. Look at the 2n minus 1 means n is equal to 1 means what will happen? 2 into 1, 2 minus 1. Therefore, sorry, 2n plus 1. Then only 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Then a is equal to 3. If n is equal to 3 means apply now, 2n plus 3 means definitely 2, 3 plus 3. 2 3s are 6 plus 3 is equal to 9, isn't it? So I think some mistake of... So yeah, it's correct now, 2n plus 1, isn't it? There 2n plus 1, no, here also 1. Therefore 2 3s are 6, 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. It's correct now. Therefore an means definitely we can say 2n plus 1. Now nth term we can write it. We found no, nth term is equal to 2n plus 1 divided by n square into n plus 1 the whole square. But the condition given, difference of 2 times. If you split the denominator 2 times means difference 1 by n square minus 1 by n plus 1 the whole square means the common denominator n square into n plus 1 the whole square. So simplify now, n square divided by n square means 1. 1 into n plus 1 the whole square means n plus 1 the whole square minus n square. Again we have to apply a plus b the whole square form, a square plus 2ab plus b square. Therefore n square plus 1 plus 2n minus n square divided by n square into n plus 1 the whole square. Now positive n square, negative n square cancel means 2n plus 1 divided by n square into n plus 1 the whole square. This is the main term. We prove now. So suppose this is easy number means we can split it. Suppose we have the different term means any critical value means partial fraction method you can have. Partial fraction means, so n square means we can write now a by n plus b by n square, then capital C by n plus 1 into capital D by n plus 1 the whole square, isn't it? Now look at their a b c d form. So a b c just equating means what will happen? The common denominator n square into n plus 1 the whole square, n square into n plus 1 the whole square. So n divided by n square, 1 balance. Therefore a n of n plus 1 the whole square. Second condition, n square cancel. Therefore b into n plus 1 the whole square. Then next condition, third one, c of, so n plus 1 cancel, c n square into n plus 1. Last term plus d into only n square, because n plus 1 the whole square, n plus 1 the whole square cancel. So now what are the opposite side? Equating 2n plus 1 divided by n square into n plus 1 the whole square means an into n plus 1 the whole square. Next one plus b into n plus 1 the whole square plus c n square into n plus 1 plus d n square the whole time divided by the common denominator n square into n plus 1 the whole square. So equating means numerator only 2n plus 1 is equal to an into n plus 1 the whole square plus b of n plus 1 the whole square plus C n square into n plus 1 plus capital D n square. Now just first you have to apply if n is equal to 0. So n is equal to 0 means definitely 1 is equal to. So 0 means what will happen? So n is equal to 0 means this is 0, C n 0, last term also 0, only balance B of n is there. So B of n means 0 plus 1 the whole square means 1 will come. Therefore B is equal to value 1. The next condition, n is equal to minus 1. So n is equal to minus 1 means 2 into minus 1 minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1 means minus 1 is equal to minus 1 plus 1. Here also 0, minus 1 plus 1. Minus last term only will come, isn't it? Therefore minus 1 is equal to D. Therefore D is equal to minus 1. Then so C also over minus 0 and minus 1 is 0. Now we can apply n is equal to positive 1. What will happen? Positive 1 means 2 into 1 true. 2 plus 1 is equal to 3 is equal to. So positive 1 means 1 plus 1 means 2. 2 square means 4a. Here also 1 plus 1 means 2. 2 square means 4b. Now here also 1 plus 1 means 2, 2c, isn't it? So 2c, last condition, dn, only d is there. What are the known values? B is equal to 1. So b is equal to 1 means plus 4 into 1, d equal to minus, so minus 1. Remaining as it is, 2c, then 4a, this is called 3a. Now look at there, 4 into 1, 4, 4 minus 1 is equal to 3. Therefore 4 and minus 1 cancel means 4a plus 2c is equal to 0. This is considered for equation number 1. Then apply n is equal to 2 means what will happen? So n is equal to 2 means, so n is equal to 2 means, look at there, 2 into 2 means 4, 4 plus 1 is equal to 5 is equal to, so 2 plus 1 3, 3 square means 9a. Sorry, 9 into 2, 18a. Then, plus, here also, 2 plus 1, 3. 3 square means 9b. Then, 2 square means 4, 4d. Then, center here also, 2 plus 1 means 3. 3 into 4 means 12c. Now, what are the known values? B is equal to 1. Therefore, 9 into 1. D means minus 1. So 4 into minus 1. Remaining we don't know. This is write it as it is. So 12C, 18A, opposite side 5. Now 9 into 1, 9. 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. Therefore 5 and 5 cancel. Therefore 18A plus 12C is equal to 0. So divided by 6 means 3A plus 2C is equal to 0. This is considered for equation number 2. So from 1 and 2, this is 1, 2, second equation, 3a plus 2c is equal to 0 means the whole term minus of plus 2c minus 2c cancel. 4a minus 3a means a is equal to 0. So substitute a value in equation number 1. Equation number 1, 4a plus 2c is equal to 0 means 4 into 0 plus 2c is equal to 0. Therefore 2c is equal to 0 means c also 0. So now we have the answer A also 0, C also 0. We have the answer A is equal to 0 as well as C also 0. Therefore A is equal to 0 means 0 plus, then B is equal to 1 is there. Therefore 1 by n square, then C also 0, 0, then D value minus 1. Therefore minus 1 by n plus 1 the whole square. Therefore 0 means definitely what the value will come? So 1 by n square minus 1 by n plus 1 the whole square. This is already we proved. Okay, some critical value means we may apply this condition, the partial fraction method. Okay, so please listen my dear students, I hope you understand. If you have any doubt, you can comment box. Okay, I will continue the next question. Okay, be stay on the line. So question number 6, okay. If kth term, tk is the k term of a geometric progression, then show that Tn minus k, then Tn, then Tn plus k also form a geometric progression for positive integer k. So solution, the condition Tk means, kth term means, so kth term means a r to the power k minus 1. Okay, now the what are the three condition is there? So Tn minus k, now Tn minus k means a r to the power, instead of k we can write it n minus k minus 1. Next term Tn, so Tn means a r to the power n minus 1. The first one consider for equation 1, second one consider for equation number 2, third one Tn plus k, therefore a r to the power n plus k minus 1. This is considered for equation number 3. So equation 2 divided by 1, equation 2 divided by equation 1 is equal to, so 2 divided by 1 means we can say now Tn, otherwise before moving to this one, what is the meaning of geometric progression? Second term divided by first term, that is T2 divided by T1 is equal to, then third term divided by second term, then fourth term divided by third term. This is will be moving on, that is called geometric progression. So according to way, second term divided by first term means Tn divided by Tn minus k is equal to, Tn is equal to a r to the power n minus 1 over a r to the power n minus k minus 1. So a cancel, therefore r to the power n minus 1. Then denominator term bring out opposite sign means plus n means minus n, minus k means plus k, minus 1 means plus 1. So minus 1 plus 1 cancel, then plus n minus n cancel, then r power k is balanced, as well as third term divided by second term. Therefore Tn plus k divided by Tn is equal to, Tn plus k means a r to the power n plus k minus 1 divided by a r to the power n minus 1. Again a cancel, therefore r to the power n plus k minus 1, plus n bring out numerator means minus n, minus 1 denominator means positive 1. So minus 1 plus 1 cancel, plus n minus n cancel, therefore here also balance, rk balances. Therefore the balance, what is the meaning? It forms an geometric progression. Therefore it forms an GP, that is called geometric progression. Okay, I will continue the next question. Moving to question number 7 from exercise 5.2, if A, B, C are in geometric progression, already we know what is the meaning of geometric progression, second term divided by first term, therefore B by A equal to C by A, therefore C by B, then cross multiply means B square is equal to C A. Then and if, one more condition is there, what is the condition? A to the power 1 by X is equal to B to the power 1 by Y is equal to C to the power 1 by Z. Now this is consider for k means equating with k each and every time. Okay, the first one a to the power 1 by x is equal to k, then b to the power 1 by y is equal to k, then c to the power 1 by z is equal to k. Therefore a is equal to k power x, as well as b is equal to k power y. The last one c is equal to k to the power z. Now what is the meaning? The condition b square is equal to c a, therefore b square is equal to ca means, b square means k power y the whole square is equal to ca k to the power z into k to the power x. Therefore k power 2 y is equal to k to the power z plus x. So base will be same, means we can equating the power of the term. Therefore 2 y is equal to z plus x, therefore y plus y is equal to z plus x. Now plus x bring out opposite side means minus x, as well as plus y bring out opposite side means minus y. See, therefore we can say, you know, x y z are in AP. Why? X y z is there, x y z means second term minus first term, so y minus x, isn't it? So y minus x, then third term minus second term, therefore z minus y, sorry made z minus y. This is our form. Okay, so please listen my dear students, if you have any doubt put in comment box. Okay, I will continue the next question. Question number 9, If the roots of the equation q minus r into x square plus r minus p into x plus p minus q, this is actually what is the form? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 means the discriminant term b square minus 4ac. The condition also r equal is there, isn't it? Therefore, we can consider equal to 0 now. So now, just equating the main term, q minus r the whole square, q minus r into x square plus r minus p into x plus p minus q is equal to 0. So just equating x square means a, no? Therefore, a is equal to q minus r, then b is equal to r minus p. The last condition, c means p minus q. P minus q. So b square minus 4ac means b square r minus p the whole square minus 4 into a means q minus r. Then c means p minus q. Now r minus b, a minus b the whole square, a square minus 2ab plus b square, r square minus 2rp plus b square minus 4 into q into p, qp minus q into q minus q square minus r into p minus rp minus into minus plus qr. Again r square minus 2rp plus p square minus, if you remove the bracket means minus 4qp, then minus into minus plus 4q square, again minus into minus plus 4rp, last condition plus into minus minus 4qr, isn't it? So now c equal to 0, no? Now starting with p square r square means what will happen? What is the term? Starting with p square, then p square q square means what is the value is there? There is actually 4q there, isn't it? 4q means plus of minus 2q the whole square. So if you remove the minus sign means definitely we can say no. Positive 4q square. The next condition plus r square, then p square q square r square. The remaining what are the term? Pq. Where is the pq? Yeah, minus 4pq, isn't it? Minus 4pq. Then qr minus 4qr. Then rp minus 2rp plus 4rp. Therefore, positive 2rp is equal to 0. Now, just again rearrange it. P square plus minus 2q the whole square. 2q the whole square. Then plus r square. Then plus 2q means minus, plus 2p means inside minus 2q. If you remove the bracket means minus 4pq. The next condition also plus 2r means inside minus 2q. Last constant true rp is equal to 0. This is, check it there, this is what is the meaning. A square plus b square plus c square plus true ab then true bc plus true ca is equal to a plus b plus c the whole square. Therefore, we can write it. What is the meaning of a? P, b minus 2q, c r. So p minus 2q plus r the whole square is equal to r square is equal to, this is whole term will be equal to a plus b plus c the whole square, isn't it? Therefore, we can say, p is equal to 0 means p minus 2q plus r is equal to 0. Therefore, p plus r is equal to minus 2q, bring it opposite side means positive 2q. Therefore, 2q we can split, q plus q, isn't it? So, just interchange now. This is not minus. Therefore, 2q is equal to p plus r. So, q plus q is equal to p plus r means p minus or q minus p, no? So, q minus p is equal to r minus q. Therefore, we can say p, q, r are in AP. So q minus p, second term minus first term, the q minus p is equal to third term minus second term, so r minus q. So hence proved. So hence proved. Okay, I will continue one of the last question. Okay, from exercise 5.2, please stay on the line. So question number 10, if a comma b comma c are respectively pth, qth, rth term of a GP, the solution. So condition a n means a r to the power n minus 1. The first one condition for ap means, so ap means a r to the power p minus 1. This is called respectively a. Then aq is equal to a r to the power q minus 1. This is respectively b. Then ar means a r to the power r minus 1, this is respectively c. So we have to prove q minus r into log a. So left hand side, what is the value? Q minus r, then log a means we can write it, what is the value respectively? A r power p minus 1, then plus r minus p. So r minus p log b is equal to a r power q minus 1 plus p minus q into log c. C means respectively a r power r minus 1. Okay, for getting this value I need more spaces. Okay, now the power rule already we know. What is the power rule? Log a power b means we can write it. Power come to the base. So b log a. As well as reverse order we can write. No, consider for b log a is equal to log a power b also. So here the base term q minus r bring out the power value. Okay. If you move on the power of the term, what will happen? Log of a to the power q minus r, then r to the power p minus 1 into q minus r. Next condition plus log of a to the power r minus p, then r to the power q minus 1 into r minus p. Then plus log of a to the power p minus q means r to the power r minus 1 into p minus q. So already we know log a plus log b plus log c means log of a b c, isn't it? So take it one time, log means the product of the a to the power q minus r, then r to the power p minus 1 into q minus r. Then again a to the power r minus p means r to the power q minus 1 into r minus p into again a to the power p minus q means r to the power r minus 1 into p minus q. Now log of, so law of indices, a to the power m into a to the power n, base same means we can add, no, a to the power m plus n. So a to the power q minus r, there plus r minus p, isn't it? So plus r minus p, next term also plus p minus q, then into r to the power, look at there, p into q pq, minus r into p minus rp, minus 1 into q minus q, minus into minus plus 1 into r means r. Next term also this is capital R, no, again q into r, sorry, made a q into r plus q r, then minus p into q minus p q, minus 1 into r, minus into minus plus 1 into p means p. Next condition also r into p r p, minus q into r minus q r, minus 1 into p, minus into minus plus 1 into q means q. So cancel term, plus q minus minus r plus r minus p plus p. So plus pq minus pq minus rp plus rp, then minus q plus q plus r minus r plus qr minus qr plus p minus p. Therefore log of a to the power 0 into r to the power 0. Anything power 0 means we know the value 1. Therefore log 1 means value already we know 0. This is called RHS. Therefore we can say hence proved. Okay. So I will continue example problem. Okay. Moving to question number 5.17. Question: find the sum of first n term of the series. Condition: 1 by 1 plus root 2. If you take conjugate means what will happen? 1 minus root 2 divided by 1 minus root 2. So numerator 1 minus root 2, denominator a plus b into a minus b. Formula: a square minus b square. Therefore 1 square minus root 2 the whole square means 2 will come. Therefore 1 minus root 2 divided by minus 1. So each and every term divided by minus means definitely positive root 2 minus 1. Second term 1 by root 2 plus root 3. So just I interchange in the denominator part. Starting with the bigger number means root 3 plus root 2. Again conjugate means root 3 minus root 2 over root 3 minus root 2 is equal to root 3 minus root 2 divided by again a plus b into a minus b. Therefore a square minus b square means so 3 minus 2. Therefore root 3 minus root 2 only, because denominator only 1. Third term 1 by, starting with the bigger term means root 4 plus root 3. Again conjugate means root 4 minus root 3 divided by, so root 4 minus root 3, the same. So numerator multiply means root 4 minus root 3 divided by again a plus b into a minus b mean 4 minus 3, root 4 minus root 3. So just I will write it. What the answer we have? First term root 2 minus 1. So root 2 minus 1. Second one, this is first pair. Then second pair root 3 minus root 2. Then third pair root 4 minus root 3. Then if you apply the next pair also, definitely what will happen? Root 5 minus root 4. So take it, next term means definitely root 6 minus root 5. So from this term, what I am saying, see, plus root 2 minus root 2 cancel. Next pair positive root 3 negative root 3 cancel. Next pair definitely take positive root means definitely next term negative root 5 will come, because root 6 minus root 5 is possible term. So then dot 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 nth term what will happen? This one definitely check it there, 1 by 1 2 3 is definitely we can write now root n. Then plus next term, this is 1 plus 1, here also 2 plus 1, here also 3 plus 1. Therefore the condition root n plus 1 is possible. So from this term, what the answer we have? Positive root 2. The bigger term minus smaller. So definitely here root n plus 1, n minus root n will come. So here minus root n also cancel. Therefore from this nth term series, definitely what the term we have balance? So nth term, so nth term series, so root n plus 1, then one more time there is minus 1 balances. Therefore minus, this is root n plus 1 minus 1. This is answer for example 5.17. okay, I will continue the next example. Question number example 5.18. find summation of k is equal to 1 to n 1 by k of k plus 1. The solution: the given term 1 by k into k plus 1, we have to expand in partial fraction method. So 1 by k plus 1 by, sorry, a by k plus b by k plus 1. Now so k into k plus 1 means what will happen? So k into k plus 1 means a into k plus 1 plus bk. Therefore 1 by k of k plus 1. So denominator same means equating numerator. 1 is equal to a into k plus 1 plus bk. Now substitute. So k is equal to 0 means what will happen? K is equal to 0 means b have 0. Therefore 1 is equal to 0 plus 1 means 1. 1 into a means a. So a value 1. Then substitute k is equal to minus 1. What will happen? Minus 1 plus 1 cancel. Therefore we can say 1 is equal to minus b. Therefore b is equal to minus 1. After getting a and b value, this is the term. What is the meaning? Just considering for a by k plus b by k plus 1. Therefore summation of k is equal to 1 to n. Instead of 1 by k of k plus 1 means we can write it. So a by k plus b by k plus 1. Again, summation of k is equal to 1 to n. A means we found what the value 1. Therefore, 1 by k plus 1 by minus 1, isn't it? This is called minus, no? Because b we have the answer minus 1. So, minus 1 by k plus 1. So, just taking the main term, substitute, k is equal to 1 means what will happen? 1 by 1 minus 1 plus 1 means true. So substitute k is equal to true means 1 by true minus. So this is first pair means then plus, because summation, no? So plus 1 by true minus 1 by 3. Then k is equal to 3 means again plus 1 by 3 minus 1 by 3 plus 1 means 4. This is third pair. Look at there. Minus 1 by 2, positive 1 by 2 cancel. Negative 1 by 3, positive 1 by 3 cancel. It will move on dot dot dot. Definitely what the term will come? 1 by n minus 1 by n plus 1. So definitely positive 1 by n also cancel. The balance we have positive 1 minus 1 by n plus 1. Take LCM. This is also one of the answer. Otherwise we can write it one more term also, one more method. Take it cross LCM n plus 1 means 1 into n plus 1 means n plus 1, then minus 1 is therefore plus 1 minus 1 cancel means n by n plus 1 also correct. Okay, we can write it true method. This is also one answer, 1 minus 1 by n plus 1, another one n by n plus 1 also correct. Okay, I will continue the next example. Example 5.20, find summation of n to n equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n square plus 5n plus 6. Solution, condition 1 by n square plus 5n plus 6. So sum product rule means the product means 6, sum means 5. Already I told you the product positive sign means selected to same sign. So definitely we can say 3 and 2. So 3 into 2 also 6, 3 plus 2 also 5. Therefore we can split n plus 3, then n plus 2. So partial fraction method, a by n plus 3 plus b by n plus 2. Therefore 1 is equal to a into n plus 2 plus b into n plus 3. Now what will happen? So substitute, n is equal to minus 2 means definitely 1 is equal to minus 2 plus 2 means a times 0 plus b means minus 2 plus 1 plus 3 means positive 1. Therefore b is equal to 1. Then next term, substitute n is equal to minus 3. So n is equal to minus 3 means 1 is equal to a into minus 1 will come, but b we have 0. Therefore a is equal to minus 1. After getting a and b value, what is the main condition? This is what is the meaning? Summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity is equal to, this is already we split a by n plus 3 plus b by n plus 2. So summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity, a is equal to what the answer? Minus 1. So minus 1 by n plus 3 plus positive 1 by n plus 2. So we have to interchange. Starting with the positive sign means summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity 1 by n plus 2 minus 1 by n plus 3. Now substitute, n is equal to 1 means what will happen? Definitely 1 by 1 plus 2 means 3 minus 1 by 1 plus 3 means 4. This is first pair. Suppose n is equal to 2 means 2 plus 3 is equal to 1 by 4 minus 2 plus 3 is equal to 5. then n is equal to 3 means 3 plus 2 is equal to 1 by 5 minus 3 plus 3 is equal to 1 by 6. So what I am telling, minus 1 by 4 cancel means, sorry, here plus 1 by 4, then minus 1 by 5 cancel means positive 1 by 5, then extra pair also definitely 1 by 6 minus 1 by 7 will come. Therefore, negative 1 by 6, positive 1 by 6. So what we have the balance, only 1 by 3. Therefore, final answer, summation of n is equal to 1 to infinity, 1 by n square plus 5n plus 6 is equal to 1 by 3. Okay. So I will continue the next example. Example 5.21, expand 1 plus x the whole power of 2 by 3 up to 4 times. Okay. So binomial nth term series, one of the important formula, solution 1 plus x the whole power n means 1 plus nx plus then n into n minus 1 divided by 2 factorial into x square, then n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into x cube plus dot dot dot. The condition when you can apply this formula, modulus x less than 1. So n is equal to is given. So n is equal to 2 by 3. Therefore, 1 plus x the whole power 2 by 3 is equal to 1 plus 2 by 3x, then plus 2 by 3 minus 1 divided by 2 into x square, then plus 2 by 3 into 2 by 3 minus 1 into 2 by 3 minus 2 divided by 3 factorial into x cube dot 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 is equal to 1 plus 2 by 3x plus 2 by 3. Simplify the LCM term. Minus 1 into 3 means minus 3. So 2 minus 3 means minus 1 by 3. So 1 by 2 means reciprocal 1 by 2 into x square. Next condition, plus 2 by 3. Again, 2 by 3 minus 1 means minus 1 by 3. Then minus 2 into 3 means minus 6. Therefore, 2 minus 6 is equal to minus 4 by 3. So, denominator 3 factorial means 1 into 2 into 3 means 6 will come. We can write it in fraction term, reciprocal. So, 1 by 6 into x cube. Now, first 2 times as it is, they had 2 cancel. Here, 2 and 6 also cancel. How many times? 3 times. Therefore, final answer 1 plus 2 by 3x plus. There is minus sign will come now because plus into minus minus. So minus 1 by 9 into x square. Then next condition minus into minus plus numerator only 1, isn't it? 1 by 3, 3, 3. 3 power 4 means 81. So 1 by 81 x cube. This is answer for example 5.21. Okay. So please listen, my dear students. If you have any doubt, please put in comment box. I'm ready to clarify your doubts. Okay. So I will continue the next session. Bye bye.